Hi, I'm Tamsin from the English Garden magazine. It's spring, so I'm going to divide my hardy water lilies. I would do this every 4 to 5 years. Water lilies are expensive plants, so if you can get 2 out of 1 or even more, then it's a bargain. I'm going to start by showing you what you need to do this. So I've got here an aquatic basket. You really do need these. You can't use an ordinary plant pot. So these are available at garden centres or specialist suppliers. And then a sheet of hessian, which is used to line the basket. And I've got here some specialist aquatic compost. You absolutely have to buy this. You cannot cut corners. It's a heavier compost than a normal multi-purpose peat or peat alternative compost. Those composts are too fibrous and it will all just float to the surface. So the water lily really needs this. Slightly more expensive than a normal bag of compost, but absolutely essential. And then I've got here the plant itself, which is about 4 or 5 years old. And I'll show you later how to find a new rhizome to make a new plant. And then you'll need a good old-fashioned kitchen knife to cut the rhizomes off because they're quite thick, so you need one of those. Secateurs to take the old leaves off the plant because they're not required on the new plant. And lastly, some good old-fashioned pea gravel. You can buy bags of this from DIY stores or garden centres. This stops the compost floating off in the pond. You must wash it because that will change the pH of your pond if you don't wash it. So rinse this through a sieve. And then to finish off, some string. And this is a brilliant trick to put the water lily back in the middle of the pond without even getting your wellies wet. Right, so I've got my water lily here. Can be a bit of a smelly job this, I'm warning you. Now you can see here, close up, the thickness of the rhizomes. Now you may have one with longer rhizomes coming off, which is absolutely perfect. Unfortunately, this has snapped off when I took it out of the pond. So you may be able to get, you know, 4 or 5 other plants. So you're looking for these thick rhizomes with an eye in the top. Okay, and then you can cut them up into sections and pop them into the pot. So I'm just going to take my kitchen knife now and take this chunk off, which has got an eye at the top. It's almost like cutting a pineapple up. Okay, so I've got my section. I'm going to put this one by. And now next thing I need is my basket, which I'm going to line with the hessian. Don't worry if you buy a bigger piece of hessian, you can just roll the edges over. So, and then I'm going to use my compost. Right, so don't fill it right to the top. We're nearly there now. Okay. Right, then I'm going to get my water lily, this new section, and I'm actually going to plant it at a sort of 45 degree angle. So, like so. I'm going to take off any old leaves or flowers because they will just die anyway and you'll have to get them out of the pond. So that's, get rid of that. And then I'm going to cover up with more compost. Do not cover the top part or the eye. If you've got an eye without foliage on it, don't cover it, leave it exposed. And remember, you've also got a layer of gravel to go on. So once that's that done, firm it in place, because although this is a heavier compost, you don't want the compost just to disappear off. So you'd be surprised how much compost you need, actually. So there we go. And then you need the pea gravel. Here we go. Now basically this stops the compost from sort of floating around, gives it a nice neat finish. Just do no more than sort of 1/2 inch of pea gravel on the top. So I'm going to cover around here. And again, don't cover the eye with gravel. Okay, there, that's plenty. Okay, so now all that's left to do is just roll the hessian under so that you've got it all tucked out the way, or you can cut it off or push it in. It's just neatening it up really so it doesn't show up in the pond. At this time of year you get very cold fingers doing this so try and pick a warm day. Right, so I'm just going to tuck this in. You can spend as long as you like making this look lovely, but that will demonstrate to you. And then lastly, I know it sounds strange, but you water the water lily. It just settles things down and gets the plant ready to go into the pond. So once you've done that, you need your string. So this is a brilliant way of putting the water lily back into the pond without getting your feet wet. It'll take two of you, but it's a brilliant way of getting the plant back into the middle of the pond. Now, what you don't want to do is put your water lily in the pond too deep. Start by putting it on a plinth of bricks if you have to, and then raising it up once the plant starts to mature. Right, so I'm going to pass the string through this side of the basket, through to the other, through here, and then another piece the other side. And I'm going to ask a friend to help me lower this into the pond using the strings. Then we just whip the strings away. So it's a really easy trick. Right, so we've got our basket, the strings through. We're going to hold it over the pond and lower it in wherever we want it. So here we are, we're lowering the pot down into the water onto a brick plinth about 20 centimetres below the surface. And we haven't even got our feet wet. So this is a brilliant way of getting the water lily into the centre of the pond. Job done.